What's going on, everybody? We're going to do things a little bit different in today's video and talk about a little bit of business and marketing, and specifically more about the I Am Bleach campaign, which started just before the Bleach live action movie had really came out. And it was really interesting because this campaign shouted out basically the Bleach live action movie, the Bleach one shot of Burn the Witch, and of course the Bleach Jet art book. And basically why this campaign happened in the first place, how much Shueisha really put into this campaign and what they did and how significant it really is. And really, numbers matter, money talks, and we'll kind of give an idea on what we think about that all together once we've kind of collected all this information. Now, of course, everything that is said in this video is an approximate. I do not want to say that these are legit the actual facts of the matter. We can only go just off market research, the kind of idea of how much Shueisha had put into this, but we do have sales of other things as well. So let's really get into it. But before we get into that, I want to give a big, huge shout out to our sponsor of this video, Echo of Soul. Echo of Soul is an MMO, but here's the kicker. It's an MMO which doesn't utilize the Trinity system, and what I mean by that as in the tank, the healer, and the DPS. Its main focus is the tank and the DPS players. So it brings this fresh feel and individuality to the game, and it works. You really have to play it for yourself and see how well and different this mechanic really is. You can have your classes which you see on screen, such as your paladins, your warriors, your warlock classes, among many others. There are over 2,000 stories, so I hope you got time because there's tons of content to explore. It's very easy to level up and get stuck right into the dungeons and raids as you get to level 10 really, really quickly. Not to mention you can start changing your attributes during that time. The game just really shows for itself just how beautiful it really is. And the dungeon bosses have this unique and style to them that I really enjoy. So click on the link in the description and start playing. And I really hope you enjoyed just as much as I did. But let's get back to the video, shall we? Now, of course, we can't really talk about how much the Bleach live action movie really made, but we know that it cost around about $3 million, with box office sales, with DVDs and Blu-rays, and of course the marketing going towards that. I unfortunately don't have, or not really specific or legitimate numbers, so I am going to make a pass on that, and seeing as it is on Netflix as well, we don't know the detriment to how much this movie actually made. But I do believe that it definitely did make a profit, that's for sure, because I do believe it broke even during its box office kind of sellings. But going by box office sales, it did seem to surpass how much it is to make the movie itself. So that was good that it was kind of in the profits, but we didn't take into consideration the advertisement and whatnot. So hopefully when we get the DVD and Blu-ray sales of that live action movie, that's going to be really interesting. And seeing as it only did get released towards the end of December and now January at the making of this video, we don't really have official numbers as of yet. So please, of course, click on that subscribe and like to stay tuned on basically the sales numbers for that. So what are we left with? Well, Burn the Witch one shot happened, and well, there's not really numbers on that. We can go by Shonen Jump sales, but that would not be a significant amount to really garner a profit margin right there. So what we can go off is, of course, the Bleach Jet art book, which, going by Aurori Khan and Comic Natalie, we have the figure of pre-order sales. Now, bear in mind that this Bleach art book was actually pre-order sales first. It was supposed to be pre-order only, but due to high demand, they made it, and they're going to continue manufacturing, which I can understand why they wouldn't have manufactured if it had flopped, because it is a very high quality product. But by going by the Bleach Jet art book sales, or the pre-order sales that actually went through and that were legit and the transaction kind of happened, it was 37,500 pre-orders on day one, which we can do a little bit of math on that by going by how much the Bleach Jet art book costs and how much these pre-orders are. And of course, it is a low ball due to the fact of, well, it's been, you know, people are still buying it, and, you know, we can probably say an estimate or approximate that it is over the 40,000 mark. Now, of course, I did do this in the US dollars, so you guys can kind of understand. And by going that it was 157 per unit, and we times that by 37,500, we get basically 5,887.5, which is a hell of a lot, and that isn't taken into consideration the tax above that. So we can garner the fact that due to day one and the fact that people are still buying it, we can say, let's lowball it and give an approximate sound. Let's look, go over 40,000, right? So we're looking above, you know, 6 million here. So let's put that into perspective. 6 million, I think that is a very successful amount for a product, especially a very expensive product at that. Now, naturally, that's all about the products and how much the product's made. So how much did the actual campaign make? Did they break even? Did they lose money? What's going on there? How much did Shueisha put in to this project? This campaign that seemed to me a little bit very surreal for something that we kind of guessed it was going to be an anime or something after that. And I do generally believe that Shueisha definitely have a plan for Bleach, because the amount of money that they have spent on this has been a tremendous amount. So, of course, as we know, on Shibuya, which is one of the biggest tourist attractions in Tokyo, it's a city that has probably one of the highest and most preferable advertising that you can have pretty much there. It's a very iconic place to be. I guess it's kind of like, you know, your Times Square of New York, or your Leicester or Trafalgar Square of London. I'm confused which one it is. I've only been to London a few times, but, you know, the big advertising cities. Now, going by the research that I have done, and again, this is an approximate, you know, you can take this as you will, but we can take this as a pretty legitimate price since as it is Shibuya and the amount of advertising. And I'm actually going to, you know, lowball the shit out of this and literally give it its bare bones. So this is a complete bare bones ideology on what the cost was. So going by a Shibuya billboard, we're looking at 630,000 yen. And that is the fact of, let's say, a day, right? And we know that the Bleach campaign actually stayed around in Shibuya for a good 7 days. But for the sake of completely lowballing this, and we're saying that that's not for a day, right? Because the information that I'm pulling up here is that these are motion billboards. And the fact that literally all over Shibuya, all over the main area, the Hachigo train station, the Shibuya train station, the Yamamoto line, we have billboards literally scattered everywhere. It is a big city. It is a big town. There's so much everywhere. You know, the pictures that I'm showing you, it wasn't a joke. Like, the amount of billboards, the amount of marketing that they gave this. So to lowball this and say, you know, it was 630. This is for a singular motion billboard. It is 630,000. But let's say that that's for a day, for all the stuff that they put on around Shibuya. Let's just give it a ballpark here for the sake of getting an idea or a grasp on how much Shueisha made. And we times that by 7, which we're not going to do. We're going to, again, lowball it. We're realistically looking here at 5,800,000 US dollars. So the question is, did Shueisha make their money back? Did they, you know, did they balance out? Did they actually get any profit from this? We don't know, because we don't have the numbers from the live action movie or Shueisha's cut from that, nor do we have the merchandising numbers, because there was Bleach live action movie merchandising. We don't have the DVD or Blu-ray sales towards that. We also unfortunately don't have the numbers for the Bleach Volume 3 Mori Tower, you know, big exposition, the art gallery exposition that they had. Because personally, when I went there, the amount of people that were buying Bleach merch essentially got sold out. So I was very surprised in how much they were making, how much they had accumulated at this point. But not to mention, we also have some sales figures for the We Do Not Always Love You light novel. So if you want to add the We Do Not Always Love You volumes as well, going in at 480 yen or 440 US dollars, we times that by 81,208 and we get 357,000 US dollars. Now, of course, we're not taking into consideration the 3 volumes of Cannot Fear Your Own Will, which I know did more. They basically got a lot more because it was more relevant. It had a lot more push behind it, a lot more promotion. So we don't know how much that is. So there's a lot of money going into this. The question is, did they make the money back? And realistically, we don't know at this point, but it's a good idea to get a conversation brewing. Here's the numbers. Here's a good ballpark of what we have and what we know. And realistically, just tell me your thoughts, guys. Here's the information. Let's open a discussion about it. But I'm very pleased with these results. I'm very pleased with the money that's being made from this. It goes to show that there is such a multi-million market for Bleach at the moment. And with these numbers at the moment, with the figures that we're getting, with the sales margins that we are, you know, having or presented to us at this time being, you know, that's free. We have one out of the three that was able to kind of garner a good statistical value of profits. That's fucking fantastic. That is very impressive. So realistically, where's that anime? That's the question, you know. What Shueisha got up next off its sleeve? I've heard some great stuff is happening in 2019. Of course, with the collaborations and, of course, with the money that the West also brings to Japan. And I heard that the live-action movie did fantastically well. So where's Bleach's next kind of journey? What's Shueisha going to do with this property now? Where's it going to lead to? That's exactly the question, because it seems like we're kind of definitely at this point, we're exhausting every avenue to go into everything but the anime, so to say. So there's going to be a point where Shueisha's like, well, oh, we've got no more products here. We're going to have to bring the anime back. And this is one of the things which is very important as well, because at Jump Festa, we also had a new figure. We had actually three new figures. There was two very like chibi forms of Ichigo and Rukia, but that was a Shueisha invested figurine set, because due to the 50th anniversary of Shonen Jump, they did one of every series, you know, Shueisha putting their own investment to get these made, not just of Bleach, but other characters or mascots within the magazine themselves. So we won't count that. But the main figurine that we get shown at the moment, and this is why it's important, and hear me out a little bit, you can choose to take this how you wish. And yes, I also am aware that Reborn also had a figure, and before we get comments going like, oh, well, Reborn soon had a figure, that doesn't mean anything. Well, kind of Reborn was celebrating a commemorative moment, and they were kind of doing this like Reborn Festa kind of event too. So that's what they were doing with that. It doesn't initially mean anything. That's probably why that existed. But we also had a grayscale of a new, well, not really new, but a remodeled, remade Ichigo that had been released for the 10th anniversary. Now, the question is for me is that why are they revamping it? Why are they reskinning it? Why are they bringing it back to us? And the question is, which it was very interesting to me, is that this is done or by a sister company run by Bandai. Now, it's very interesting that Bandai have gotten involved in this as an external company, because generally speaking, we can use the Broly movie as the perfect example, is that when the trailers were going out for the Dragon Ball Z Broly movie, nobody knew who the villain was. We kind of found out who the villain was because the merchandisers had already made the merchandise for the movie before the movie comes out. And that's how it works, is that the merchandisers who know that a show is coming back or invest into a show want to make the products before the product or the service or the show is out. So they have merchandise ready to put out on shelves for when that product is on the air or in the theatres, etc., etc. So the fact that, you know, it was a very interesting, and again, take it as you will, this is a very interesting theory. It's not a one that you should definitely throw away, but the fact that it should go from the 10th anniversary has been brought back, it's been grayscaled, it's shown to us that it's in production, makes me question, well, why is it going back into production? Why are they redoing these models? Why are they reselling it? And I think simply the question is because Bandai are making more merchandise for when there's a reveal or there is a product out there to basically sell the said merchandise or the figurines. And that follows up with also Bandai are also putting out some new little like keychain plushy things as well. That's really interesting. I wonder why Bandai as an external company is investing into the Bleach franchise. That is very you know, it gets the brain flaring a little bit. So I am going to leave it off with that. Tell me your guys' courses thoughts in the comment section down below. Give me your thoughts and opinions on this. Of course, none of everything in this video is of course legitimate. We are going off estimates or approximates here. All I'm doing is giving you the numbers and giving you a rough idea on the kind of scale of money that we're talking here, and throwing a few little bits and pieces in there. So how much did the Iron Bleach campaign make? Well, let's just say definitely made over 10 mil, that's for sure. And that's not a number to laugh at for a series that's been off the air for, well, 6 years. And a series that basically has ended 2 years ago in its manga format. So I'm very pleased that a lot of money, especially millions upon millions, is actually being invested into this. But I'm going to leave it off with that, and I'm going to stop rambling. I'm going to catch you, motherfuckers, that you guys, of course, have this fine day being handsome. Of course, if you want some merch or if you want to donate, there is links in the description down below. But as always, people, peace out.